All right, Coach. Big win tonight against Ohio University. Grudge match. You're not happy that I made a grudge match trophy last year and you guys lost it right out of the gate. And I think you got a pretty good record against Coach Greenlee and Ohio University. But you guys lose that thing, and I think you were pretty mad at me. Was that true?
I wasn't mad. It was just we didn't have – they had a better team than us last year, and we all of a sudden someone decides to make – after 10 years of beating them in a row, someone decides to make a plaque. So I wasn't very happy about it, no.
What do you think, you know, now you guys got it back? Now how do you feel about the rivalry?
My thing is it's – I'm glad we won. It's important. It's important to win home matches. It's important to win. If you looked at our season, we haven't been very consistent. We haven't been very good. I thought we wrestled pretty well here tonight, and I thought that hopefully we can look back at this match in a month or 2 months and say that was the turning point for our team. Our guys are way better than we've performed. You know, it's easy to come at home, wrestle well in front of a big crowd. That's the easy thing. It's hard to go to Edinburgh. It's going to be freezing up there. You know, we go there Sunday, so let's see what happens on Sunday to see where our team's at. But I like how we did today. I'm really happy with how we performed, and you know, we got two backups to a backup to a backup wrestling like they did. So it's just, you know, we all have the same problems, the same issue. I know Edinburgh has some guys out, so they're gonna have the same issues we have, and you know, sometimes you got to be able to. That's what a team is all about. That's why you have a team and other guys that you can use to go out and wrestle. And let's just see what happens from here on out.
You're basically like a team of fringe guys as far as NCAA qualifiers. Mimo's on the bubble.
Yep.
Buckwalter now, he's been on the bubble. Mac is a guy who's in, I think. You know, Mac's a guy who he's going to bring a spot. He's done a heck of a job. But, you know, Marsh, he's now on the bubble.
Yep.
Got all these guys on the bubble, Coach. What do you got to do to get those bubble guys to St. Louis for you?
You got to be consistent. You just have to be consistent. You have to beat the guys you're supposed to. And if you wrestle a ranked guy, maybe upset him or you lose to a guy. But you have to beat the guys you're supposed to beat. That's, you know, that's the bottom, the only way to look at it. And if you're going to lose the guys that you're not supposed to as far as the rankings, there's a good chance you're not going to bring a spot and you won't qualify. But, you know, like, you have to beat the guys that are behind you to secure it.
Tyler Small's been a roller coaster. And he's 27-6 now. He's got a ton of matches.
Yeah.
He's probably going to bring a spot. You know, he's had some good wins.
Yeah.
A ton of opens. You know, was ineligible first semester for dual competition. He's had a mixed bag season after tonight's performance for me, Coach.
Yeah, after tonight, he can't. If that's how it's going to be the rest of the year, then he's going the wrong direction, which I'm sure he knows. We've had a conversation with him about it. He knows he wrestled horribly. He ran out of gas. He kind of let the guy hang around long enough, and you know, made two real nice shots and just didn't convert him the right way. And next thing you know, he let the guy kind of work himself into a win rather than him, the other kid going up and beating him. He did the kid just enough and hung around long enough he's like, hell, I can beat this guy. Why can't I beat him? And that's what wrestling's all about. That's what happened. Tyler Buckwalter hung around long enough that he said, I'm good enough to beat this guy. Gerald Spahn, who has no business wrestling on a varsity level at this point, hung around with that guy long enough to say, I can beat this guy. So, you know, it's part of wrestling. And we got to get Tyler going the right direction, because if his goal is just to get to the national tournament, if he keeps wrestling like that, it's not going to happen.
Having the Spawns and the Valons, the guys that step in there and just fight really hard, how important is that, having guys like that around?
It's really important, because, you know, right now we have a situation where we had a kid that just felt like he couldn't wrestle. And our doctors, everyone gave him permission. It's about him. And our guys aren't very happy about that right now. And I'm happy with our guys that they came out and said something that, you know, like I said, everyone's hurt at this point in the year. It's about coming out and learning how to compete when you're not feeling 100%. And you're never going to feel 100% probably from this point on the rest of the year, so why aren't you competing? And that's something that when you have guys like Vallant and Spahn and Mac, and hell, Mac hasn't missed a match this year. Ian made it back, which is great to have him back, but Mimo hasn't missed a match this year. And you need guys that are just going to come in and rough their way through the season, and that's what some of these guys are doing.
Is Ian back 100% for you?
I don't think he's 100%. I don't think he's been 100% all year. You know, last year he had an injury right around the same time, and he turned it up right at the end of the year, and it worked out for him. I think I'm hoping this year that this is his point where he can say, all right, I've got 8 more duels left. I'm going to really narrow my focus in on what my goals are and hopefully compete for a national championship, because he's good enough to. You know, it's just a matter of – and also I think Ian's a lot smarter and we give him all credit for it. He might be knowing – he might know exactly what he's doing, and however that might be said. And, you know, I don't – he's a guy that needs time off away from the sport to be successful. And as long as he continues on the path that we need him to the rest of the season, I'm happy. I'm not happy that he took this time off, but I'm happy that he's back with us and that hopefully he's refreshed and ready to finish off the season and like he did last year.
you know, looking at some of the lopsided dual losses, Arizona State. I was looking at the results, and I understand what college duels are.
Yeah.
I understand 1 and 2 point matches are 50-50 sometimes, and it steamrolls on you. How do you address those? And I looked at some of those results. I'm like, how are they getting blown out by Arizona State? I mean, Coach, there were a couple 8-2 matches where you guys just got absolutely smashed at the Virginia Dose. How do you address that?
I think if you have to address it match by match. If you look, we had Virginia Dose, we had 5 walk-ons starting for us. And if you know anything about college wrestling, you know that usually your walk-ons aren't guys you want wrestling. Now, we got guys that have come in and done a great job for us, but they weren't our first person when we started the season off. And not to say that every team needs walk-ons, and we needed them. Tonight we had a few walk-ons wrestling for us. So, but when you're
Spawn with a huge win, man.
A walk-on. Del Venus is a walk-on. Volant's a walk-on. These are guys, we had 3 walk-ons this time instead of 5.
Two of them got wins.
Two of them, yeah. Like I said, but that's part of the developmental process. But ultimately, you know, you have the Tutulos, you have the... You've got the Wheelers on your team. You got the Marshes wrestling. You got the Ians. That's, you know, when I started the season off, you look at who we had, 8 national qualifiers returning. I'm thinking, all right, we got a good team. And all of a sudden, guys get hurt, guys get injured. Dell starting us off with a win, if you know our team, then Mac doing exactly what he's supposed to do, really got us going, got our team going. I think that, you know, I think Buckwalter's one of the guys that, if the team's winning, he believes he can. And, when, you know, that's how it works in wrestling. I remember our best teams were when we had 25-pounders that would go out and get our team rolling. And for 4 years when we had Nikki Belli on, he went out there, and no matter how much weight he cut, how tired he was, he went out there and busted his balls to win. And ultimately, it got the rest of our team knowing how important it is. And we're still, you know, we're still looking for Del. Del can be that person. He just needs to realize that he's got a pretty big responsibility rather than just being the first guy out there.
All right, Coach. So that's it. One by one, that's how you...
Day by day. I think our goal right now is tomorrow's practice. Let's get in, get one more guy healthy, however it works. Get there, worry about tomorrow, then worry about Edinburgh, and then worry about the next day. I think we're a team that really needs to... take day to day. We can't worry about Central Michigan in 3 weeks or Eastern Michigan in 2 weeks. We've got North Carolina State and Old Dominion in between there. So we got to worry about each match individually. And hopefully, like I said, hopefully in 2 months we can look back at this match and saying, all right, we got guys back. We're doing the right things. Our guys are wrestling. And hopefully we turn the corner. Or at least we're driving now 60 miles an hour. Hopefully we can keep it going.
All right, Coach, you got anything else for me?
That's it.
Thanks for the time. Congratulations on the win.